Welcome to the Stop Show. We are the Random Chance Band.
We started off, Chris and I, we added bass player Jean, and it all came about a little bit at a time. We were doing a show for the 24th of June in Sutton. That goes back to 2013. And we didn't have a name, and they wanted us to have a name. So I was on the phone with Malcolm, just chatting about what we're gonna use for a name. Malcolm said the words, well, we got together by random chance. So I said, you just found the name of the band, Malcolm.
Oh, yes, sir.
So Malcolm was, oh, he did? I said, yeah. You just said random chance.
So that's he's a creative.
That's any other kind of chance is fixed.
Yeah. That started with Chris and I at the Salle Alexis-Gérald Pelletier to do a fundraiser show. And Chris got the only standing ovation for Roy Orbison's Crying.
It's fun to sing Roy. It's getting a little harder as one goes on, but it's a lot of fun to sing Roy. I like to try and channel him sometimes. Years we've raised just over $25,000, and the clock is still ticking
for different charities and
cancer
research and you name it.
Well, instruments for kids,
all
kinds of different things.
Yeah,
CIDI.
Radio station.
Well, I used to be on the board at CIDI. It was one of the first volunteer things I did when I retired, and I'm a firm believer in a community radio station. What is their saying? Being who we are. You know, it's very important to support the community and listen to a radio station that can reflect who you are. And they were a big help in promoting the gig. But they brought out a lot of people, and I just take my hat off to them. They're doing such a good job.
For me, what's important is local talent. Yeah. And when I turn it on, I'm hoping to hear some local talent. And I had it on the other day, and sure enough, Sarah Biggs comes out with it, nice. With Don Quixote. Yeah. And it was so great to hear that, you know, because I love Sarah Biggs. I love that song. And those are the kind of things you'd like to hear more, I guess, on that radio station.
And this area has so many talented musicians. It's incredible.
Yeah, it's amazing. Yeah.
Incredible. Well, I know some of y'all ain't never been down south too much, so I'm going to tell you a little story about this so you'll understand what I'm talking about. Well, down there they got a plant that grows in the woods and the fields. Looks something like a turnip green, but it ain't no turnip green. Everybody call it poke salad. That's poke salad. Well, I used to know a girl who'd go out there in the evening, pick herself a mess of it, carry it home, cook it for supper. And if they had any left over, they'd hang it out to dry and smoke it. 'Cause it's legal in this country. Well, down in Louisiana, where the alligators grow so mean, there lived a girl, I swear to the world, made the alligators look tame. Poke salad in it. Poke salad in it. Said it was a shame, 'cause your mama was working on a chain gang. A wretched, spiteful, straight razor told woman, oh Lord have mercy. Every evening for supper time, she'd go down by the truck patch and pick her a mess of poke salad. Carry it home in a toaster, poke salad, and the gator's got your grin at. Chomp, chomp, chomp. Everybody said it was a shame, 'cause your mama was working on a chain gang. A mean, vicious, wretched, straight razor-toned woman, oh Lord have mercy, pick me a mess of that poke salad. Was lazy in no count, claimed he had a bad back, and all her brothers were fit for was stealing watermelons out of my truck. But folks had it in alligators got your granny. Ooh, everybody said it was a shame, 'cause your mama was working on a chain gang. A mean, vicious, wretched, spiteful, straight razor totem with high heels. Oh, give me a mercy, pick me a mess of that poke salad. Take a little chomp. Take a little chomp, chomp. Take a little chomp, chomp, chomp. Take a little chomp, 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 chomp.
The Sutton Legion was our first gig, and then from there, the Sal Pelletier, the Lakeview Inn, local places in Knowlton and Sutton, and we've done a couple of gigs in Cowansville. Oh, and we did the Mansonville Summer Festival one summer as well. Yeah. And we did Town Chippers Day, that's true. We've done Brown Fair a couple of times as well. So over the years it's grown, but still local.
And we teamed up with CIBC years ago with the four branches or five branches in Bromissisqua. They were doing a fundraiser for breast cancer. And that was one of the best selling. They sold over 200 tickets.
That was huge.
And we played at the Mo Sutton Main Chalet and basically filled that place. It was a real good event.
Yeah, we love the feedback we get from the crowd. The dance floor is always packed. Everybody's singing along. They know our songs. They know the old songs, the old rock and roll songs. And that's what you feed off of.
that we played for the church in Knowlton a couple of times already for completely free, and I'm very happy because me, the worst, the best thing is to play.
We were hedging our God bets.
Right.
We were doing that for free.
Right, right. Yeah. And we
paving the way.
Paving the way.
Services financiers ARB ont l'expertise nécessaire pour tous vos besoins de tenue de livre, rapport d'impôt, TPS TVQ, état financier et services de paye. Ralph Buschenbaum et Benoît Carrier sont là pour vous. 450-292-5835.
My only experience in rock and roll is playing with those guys. When I started playing with those guys, I had no clue. No, oh, of course, when I was young, I listened to these songs a little bit because everybody was. One thing I gotta say though, I'm still not a rock and roll fan, but I'm a Random Chance Band fan.
Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah.
This is one thing I can say. I love to play with these guys, and hopefully it's going to keep on going for years.
We've been converting them slowly. I remember when we first met Jean at the Sal Pelche that John referred to, Jean said something like, well, you know, I'm not into that rock and roll too much. I like Latin music and jazz. I don't do rock and roll.
He was playing the stand-up bass when he played with us at the
But South, then he admitted, and then he admitted to me being a fan of James Jamerson of the Funk Brothers, and then I thought, okay, there's a chance, a random chance, if you will, and so it came out, and he started, oh, I like that song, yeah. And now he's playing like Bill Wyman bass lines.
My favorite is playing and people are dancing, and that, you know, playing with these guys, people dancing. It doesn't get any better than that. So, you know, and the fact that we can help various organizations in the area.
Yeah. We're all older. Majority are retired, and we have a chance to play. We practice twice a week, which has gone a long way to making our sound better. And we learned, as Don called us the other day, we're like a family now. So it's kind of neat.
My brother played with Marty quite a bit in the early years. Then I stopped playing entirely, so in retirement I picked up the guitar again. And actually part of the band's formation was my brother became sort of semi-professional in Pensacola, Florida. So he was visiting, and that's how Chris came on board, and we're looking for a singer. So we got Marty on drums, I got George Dimitrik on bass, I played rhythm, and my brother came to play lead, and Chris came in to sing with us. And it was just fun.
So I go over on a Sunday afternoon around 2 o'clock,
and I had the acoustic.
Had a beer in the backyard, and hi, how are you? We go to John's garage, beautiful garage, and we played 2 hours that Sunday afternoon, and that was done. And John said, "Well, that was fun. You want to do it again tomorrow?" Said, yeah. So we did it again on Monday. Want to do it again? Yeah. We did it again on Tuesday. 3 days in a row, and then we were hooked. I mean, from then on, we just built into where we are today.
I was at one of their gigs at the Legion, and John approached me while I was sitting there. He says, "You want to get on stage and sing with Chris? Do a song with Chris?"
It was an Eagles tune.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what it was.
Yeah.
I said, "Did you warn Chris?" He said, "Yes." I said, "Okay." So I did a song with them, and then they invited me back to practice, and that was it.
I had heard Don sing a little bit at the Red Room, Angel Forest, the Auberge and Glenn Sutton. We're both lived in Glen Sutton at the time, as John still does. And I heard Don sing a couple of times, and as far as we were concerned, you know, Bonnie Raitt. You sang, remember at the time, you said, "Come on, Don, sing us some Bonnie Raitt."
Angel Forrest asked me to get up and do it with her, and I said, "Are you crazy? I don't know the words." I said, there's no way. She says, it's okay, I'll stand right behind you and give them to you. As I sing?
Yeah.
She says, yes.
I remember that very well.
So she was right behind my head, giving me the words, and then I'd sing them. So that was fun.
Toil or danger in that bright land to which I go. I'm going there to see my father. I'm going there no murderer. I only go going over Jordan. I'm only go, going home. I know dark clouds will gather on me. I know my way is rough and steep. In beautiful fields lie just before me. In God's redeeming and angels' keep. I'm going there to see my father. I'm going there, no motorhome. I only go, going over Jordan. I'm only going, going home.
The band's been together for 6 years. Trevor was there for probably the first three. And then he got ill, and I had just been asked prior to his leaving the band, I was just asked if I would come and work the soundboard, which I did. And so I sat in with the band at a couple of gigs just running the soundboard, and so that to some extent familiarized me with the tunes. And then Trevor just became sicker and sicker, and then he just died. As a kid, I started playing drums. I was probably 12 or 13 years old with my buddies. Didn't know how to play the drums, but I had drums and learned how to play. And my buddies were exactly the same thing with guitars and keyboards, and so we created a band. So I, after high school, studied a little bit of music in Montreal, classical music in Montreal. I didn't want to be part of the city anymore, so I came back to the country, started a business, and I went for 35 years without playing. You know, you have to just start all over again, practicing, and but that's fun. That's what it's all about. You know, that's the really good thing about the Random Chance is everybody really, really gets along well. There's no superstars, and there's no attitude, and there's no none of that.
Riding along in my automobile, my baby beside me at the wheel. I stole a kiss at the turn of a mile, my curiosity running wild. Cruising and playing the radio, with no particular place to go. Riding along in my automobile, I wanted to tell her the way I feel. So I told her softly and sincere. She leaned and whispered in my ear, cuddling more and driving slow, with no particular place to go. We parked our way on the Kokomo. The night was young and the moon was gold, so we both decided to take a stroll. Can you imagine the way I felt? I couldn't unfasten a safety belt. Riding along in my calaboose, still trying to get a seatbelt loose. All the way home I held a grudge for the safety belt that wouldn't budge. Cuddling more and playing the road, with no particular place to go. Now that's rock and roll, right?
Thanks for tuning in
to The Stop Show.
We are the
Random Chance Band.
Right.
We love you!
You did pitching words.
Right.
You're right.
Yeah.